Hello everyone, this is gshock high fashion channel back at you with another gshock unboxing and review video. I already covered most about the watch, however let me do it all over again because it's totally different when you're talking about photos and the actual watch on your hand. If you guys didn't know, this is the March 2017 release Hotei 35th anniversary G-Shock watch. It's not G-Shock, it's the anniversary. I got confused many times. This model was released in Japan and also outside of Japan, if I'm not mistaken. The model number is DW-5600HT-1JR. HT stands for Hotei, 1 stands for black, J for Japan domestic market version, R for special type of packaging that this model have, and there it is. This is the special packaging. There it is. There's the barcode back there. It explains all about the watch already just from the model number, if you know about G-Shock, of course. If you don't, let me pop this thing up. One thing you should know that Hotei also made a collaboration before during his 30th anniversary in Guitardom. And yeah, by the way, Hotei is a man, a person named who are a very well-known guitarist in the music industry. If you are into music, the name will probably ring a bell already by now. If it haven't, you probably don't care much about music or guitar in general. By the way, this is the new design box. The previous version come with a whole black box with all this black here in white colorway. Just reverse all that and then you get this new release box, which is white. I think this thing looks stand out more, I guess. All of this pattern design is actually Hotei main logo or trademark, something like that, and this is his actual logo. Actually, I don't know what this thing means or taken from, but it looks very very dope and it is one of a kind. I mean totally one of a kind. When you see this anywhere else or you see this logo being stamped on a t-shirt, on a paper, on a G-man or whatever, on a watch, you know that is Hotei merchandise right away. Just that's how iconic this thing is, you know, if you know, of course. By the way, let me show you guys the tin case as well. Similar type of design, this more overwhelming design all around. The tin case very unique, very complicated as well. I guess that's how complicated playing guitar is for him. At least he's very very good at it. And at the bottom part of the tin case we have more writings or G-Shock and Hotei logo over there, so it's a collaboration. And what it says down here: since its birth in 1983, G-Shock have evolved constantly in pursuit of toughness. You'll find the latest fruit of this philosophy inside the box in your hand. And I believe these are the production company that made this collaboration with G-Shock, you know. I don't know about this industry, man, but here is the international warranty card. Need to have this, you know, just in case something happened to your watch. Leave a link to download your English manual because I'm buying it from Japan. You're gonna get a Japanese manual that looks like this. Let me bring it up a little bit. Oh, this looks like the cheaper version of it. Look at that. You can open it up all the way so big. Bam! All of a sudden, full frame. Anyway, let me get out of the way because this guy will only operate on which model is that? 3229. Let me pop it up in 3, 2, 1. Wait, it's stuck. 1, bam. Wow. Well, there are a lot of detailed photos online way before this model was released, so it's not a big surprise at all. And of course, this model was released in March, and I have been seeing a lot of these photos on the Instagram. A lot of you guys already been sharing about this. You guys copped this way earlier than I am. I didn't plan to cop this actually. It just happened to happen. You know, sometimes things just happen and it ended up on this table right here. You know what, let me put it all out of the way. I really need to make a separate space for me to just display all this. Maybe around here or here or up here. Okay, you know what, let me open this thing up. There it is. Okay, there it is. Okay, this model was released in Japan at a retail price of 17,000 yen plus tax, so it's gonna be 18,000 yen something, which is pretty pricey actually. So that's why I didn't plan to cop this at all. But a friend of mine recently contacted me, and he already owned the watch, and he said he needed the money, and he is willing to sell this to me at a very, not a very, pretty cheap price. I mean, lower than the retail at least. And you know what? Sometimes we need to help a friend out, and that's how this model ended up with me. Okay, we talk about the box, we talk about the tin case. Now let's talk about the watch. Okay, first impression. Well, holding this on hand, you really need to feel this by yourself. I don't know, feels pretty odd. The material feels more plasticky than a rubbery. It feels pretty, I'm not to offend anyone, but it feels pretty cheap. But the price is only 17,000 yen, but I don't know if this is better than the previous release 5600 or this is less. However, the printing feels very, very good. I mean, feels so soft on there. I don't know what they use on making this. Probably printing or painting or decal. I don't know. Look at that. You guys probably could tell. You guys need to have a closer look like that. Look at that. Look at all those tiny designs all around. I'm not sure if it's random or not, but I don't think it is random. If you bought a Hotei as well, you're gonna get a similar design as this. So yeah, this you could use this video as a legit check as well, because all Hotei from 5600 are all just the same. And, you know, you need to have all this to ensure that you get the original version, since you know the backplate of this model says that it is made in China. So if you don't know about G-Shock, you're probably gonna flip out and think that this is a fake G-Shock. Just know this is legit, even though it feels cheap. To be honest, it sure really feels cheap. By the way, it's probably because it is made in China, you know. So that's why it feels cheap. The quality is different. DW-5600HT model number 3229 module. I'm not sure if you guys can see. Look at that. Look at that, somewhere around there. And they have very unique type of side piece that I like the most. It's add more efforts, and probably that is why guess you need to price it a little bit. Even though this part feels cheap, the side piece and also the buckle feels expensive, because it has this black IP process steel on there. To look at that, black buttons, you barely able to see, although the screws are just silver. This is the buckle in black color with Casio Japan sign below, which is impressive thing to have. Really appreciate this sort of tiny details, you know, as a collector and also a fan of G-Shock in general. I really love my watch to have all this. The band keeper just simple black matte finishing all over. Look at that, the bottom part just simple. I just imagine that they use a black watch and just print the Hotei design logo, all over the watch, and bam, done a collaboration G-Shock. Now, on the faceplate, it looks more cleaner. This similar like a BB, the Blackout Best, if this is a 100 model, and they'll have add all this white square pattern on there, and it looks pretty dope. Look at that. Look at it from a distance. Very unique, very artistic, music is also a form of art, so it fits to the team and it fits to the man himself, the person who behind this all this crazy logo. I never had even once a thought about designing this sort of logo at all. Like, it's very confusing. I don't know if this symbolizes something, a pattern where the secret code or lettering in there. I don't know, but it looks very, very unique. It have the same thing on the back plate and also at the back lighting for this model. Look at that, in EL green with a red logo popping at the back there. Very simple, this 600. You know what, let me put it on wrist to show you guys how this thing works on wrist. Of course, you guys really need to see this on wrist, because when you find this on the street, you really, really need to have the ability to tell if that is legit or not, if that is Hotei collab or what. Look at that. So this is how it's gonna look like from a distance. If you are spotting this outside, look at that. Very neat looking watch. It's very lightweight. A standard 5600 is very sleek, small, and fit. Pretty fit, and it's very lightweight. So yeah, you're gonna get all that interesting design, and also the square iconic design. If you are a guitarist, or if you are a fan in music, even in general, you're probably gonna need to have one of these in your collection, because it symbolizes something. It has meaning. It's not just like square watch with square patterns. Not just that. There's more to it. You know, Hotei guitarism written on the faceplate. They have shock resistance down there. Very neat and beautiful font. At home time, we're gonna have day, date, and time. Simple. We have single alarm, countdown timer, a stopwatch, and back to home time. And I mean, the module is just simple. It's like the regular 1600, although, I mean, not this one. Regular 1600 type of module, except on a square model. Yeah, that is all it got. They need to know about this Hotei 35th Anniversary G-Shock Guitarism model. And this is the back part of the price tag and the rest. Look at that. Very simple one. Okay. And I guess that is all it about this G-Shock model. I don't want to consume too much time. This has been too long of a video. I hope you guys found this video useful and informative as well. Leave a like and also subscribe for more G-Shock related contents like all this in the future, man. More new G-Shock incoming soon as well. Thank you very, very much for watching, guys. This is G-Shock High Fashion Channel. Oh, by the way. And out. Yo.